Good afternoon, folks. Now I had no idea. I really didn't think I'd be making any more fidget cube videos. After the number that I've already done, I honestly thought there was nothing more to do any videos about. But I felt that this one is basically an update. And I felt it was important enough to share, particularly share with backers of the official Antsy Labs cube, who paid on Kickstarter and helped back the project. So when I got my rewards 6 weeks ago, whenever it was, one of the cubes had some bit issues. It arrived basically loose in the box like that, as many of you have seen. The case all cracked up, and due to that, it had done some injury to the cube itself, to the functions, particularly to two functions on there. I'm not going to kind of say what those faults were. But it had broken two of the features pretty much to the point where they were not rewarding to play with at all. So I spoke to the guys at Antsy Labs, the founders there, and they were interested to know what the faults were. I shot video and everything to show them what was going on. And they were happy, and they said, "Yep, yeah, no problem, and we'll get that replaced for you." So, I mean, that was probably 6 weeks ago I first reported it. It's taken time to get through the ticketing system, but they've been really good. Just although it's been a long time to get messages back and forth, considering how many people are emailing them currently, I think the time in which they did this was really good, and it shows how committed they are to perfection, to getting these official fidget cubes right. So that's the original one, with a couple of faults. Like I say, I'm not going to take it out and show you, but a couple of other things to note about the early cubes that came out was that the stand inside would detach from the bottom of the case itself, and then the fidget cube would detach from the stand, so you'd have two different pieces in there rattling about and damaging each other, damaging the case, and it wasn't very good. So it's interesting to have a look and see how the latest revision of cubes that are rolling out currently have come, because this morning a huge ginormous box arrived. I thought, what's that? Opened it up, huge amounts of bubble wrap and everything, and inside was my replacement. So, like I say, it's taken 6 weeks-ish for it to arrive, but considering how slam they are, I think that's pretty good going, really. Now, the bubble wrap surrounding the casing when it arrived was absolutely perfect. It was like a Christmas present. It was so well folded. It was really impressive, and of course, it's got the fidget sticker on there, the bubble wrap, keep your fidget cube safe on its journey to you. Take a moment to treat yourself and pop a few, which is fun. Now I've opened this up just to have a quick look and check everything's good, which it is. So let's carry on. So we'll do is get this out the same way. Slide it out from its bubble wrap, and there we go. Now, straight away, cube's still attached. It's not rattling around inside. It's come all the way from America, this one. The customs label and address label said it was from the US. And it's remained stuck down for the entire journey, which is quite impressive. That's about 6,000 miles, I think it's travelled, so that's great. The display case is absolutely crystal clear, perfect. No cracks, no dings, no dents. So, really nice to be able to display it in that. We'll pop it open. We know these cases can be a bit of a test. I'll just put the camera down for a second. There we go. So, pop it open, take the lid off. Now, here's our fidget cube inside. And that is really, really stuck to that base there, and really is kind of not going anywhere. So pry it off, there we go. And straight away I can see that they've changed their packaging. On the original cubes, it was just a single piece, a single line of this white kind of sticky back tape holding it down to the cube. What they've done now is obviously had this custom made sticky plate, so it's as a cross, so it's held down with the die side down. I mean, that's basically covering every bit of flat space on the cube. Now, it's left a bit of sticky, but I mean, that's no problem. I'll get an ear button and clean that off in a bit. So yeah, that's awesome. That's really great that that's arrived and travelled that far without detaching from the cube. Now inside we got our cotton bag, which we love. It's a really nice cotton bag, really nicely well made. Not cheap and velvet like some of the fakes we've seen. And then again, a big difference. Straight away you can see that base has now been modified and is designed. That is absolutely solid to that base now. I think it's probably been glued down, because the original ones just used sticky back, double-sided kind of tape or something originally. Now you can kind of see that these have been glued in to make sure that these do not detach. And that tape is still really sticky, so that's really awesome. Let's move to the cube. It's backward edition, as you know, the Kickstarter green. I hope the camera is showing that. Again, people have asked me loads of times, what's the green actually look like, you know, off camera? And it is an exact, I'd say it's a 99% match to a Kickstarter green color. So yeah, the color is fantastic. It's good to see there's no dents or dings in the cube. We'll just go through the features. So the front dial all work nicely, nice little clicking, nice bit of tactile feedback there. The black ball bearing, which is really cool, goes in nicely, spins freely in its housing, which is great. The switch on top is great. In fact, I think that might have been altered slightly, maybe, because that feels like there's a bit more friction there. It takes just a little bit more to make that trip, not a lot, but before, you could, as soon as you touched it, it would go. Now you have actually got to put a bit of force on that to make it trip, and that's great. And also it still rocks back and forth, which is brilliant. Now, over to the spin dial. This is one of the features that had some issues on my original cube. We'll look at it from the side. You can see that it's perfectly flat. That's just brilliant. And yeah, that's great. That's really, really better now. That goes all the way around 360 degrees and you can spin it with just your thumb to it over the little noggin on the dial, and it spins perfectly with just those little clicks as it goes around. But there's no stoppages, you don't need to use a lot of force. That's 10 times better than the cube I got early on. The dice face, your two silent buttons, nice and springy. So you can see how springy they are by how far they return back. And your two outside noise making dice buttons are really good. And then the middle one, which is a bit lighter and gives a nice different clicky noise to the kind of thud that the outside ones do. So you got that one and that, so perfect on my dice. We'll move round. The worry stone is the worry stone. As I've said a million times, I'm really not that interested in that. It's, I suppose it fills the side, but I would have put an extra feature on there if it had been me. And round to the glide. This was the other feature that had problems, and now it's perfect. Moves absolutely flawlessly in all directions. There's nothing that stops it in any direction. You can go right down the outside, and so they've sorted that perfectly. Side view again shows that the glide top is absolutely perfectly aligned. I think that's where the damage probably came from on my original one, was probably the impact on this, which also knocked spin dial out of alignment as well. And of course, I mean, it basically, you know, it stopped these two functions working anywhere near as well as they should. But now they're working perfectly, and everything's great. So to recap, they've fixed the stickiness to hold the cube onto the base. It all seems to go well in transit now. Less likely, I mean, before you had a sort of 10% chance of getting a case that wasn't cracked, whereas now you're pretty much guaranteed with that amount of sticky on there that your case is going to arrive and be crystal clear like this one, so you can use it as a display, which is awesome. And yeah, and to me it feels like they may have just tweaked a few things in that cube. I'm not sure. It may just be that my first cube, the damaged one, was, you know, damaged in such a way that the features were all behaving differently. But now, I mean, that top rocker switch definitely needs more pressure to make it trigger. And like I say, they've really fixed the spin dial on the side, and the glide joystick is completely different now to how it was. I thought that the problem was a lot less than it now appears to be. Now I see how it works properly. I can see that the glide joystick and the spin dial were both damaged way more than I actually thought originally they were. So that's really fantastic. And everything else works brilliantly. So that's awesome. Thank you guys. At Antsy Labs. As I've said before, the official cube is the best fidget cube out there. There are so many unofficial cubes now. But these Antsy Labs official cubes are just brilliant. They are the best by a mile. And you know, if you're gonna get a fidget cube, you're best pre-ordering one on the antsylabs.com website, where you can pre-order, and they're aiming to deliver some point this month. It might go over into April, but they are now rapidly moving through the last of the Kickstarter backers, and so get your pre-order in. It's likely to arrive quicker than ordering a cube from China, which could take up to, you know, 4 or 6 weeks to arrive. I mean, normally it's about 2 weeks, but sometimes it's 4, sometimes it's 6, sometimes it's longer. Antsy Labs, these cubes really are the best cubes available. The features all are fantastic, and you know, the quality of the product, quality of the packaging, the quality of the extras is now they've sorted out and refined a few things. I think that's absolutely perfect. Just briefly, I don't like doing this because this I wanted this to focus on the Antsy Labs cube, but also this didn't really deserve a video all by itself. As you know, when it comes to the fake fidgets out there, my favourites are the little midget fidgets, the little yellow and blue type midget fidgets. Now, over the past few weeks since I last made a video, some new cubes have been popping up. I've shown one of these before very briefly, but now there's loads out there, and I don't see these as a replacement or a fake for these. I see these as kind of an extra, really. And they're these little tiny micro fidgets. They are absolutely minuscule. Let's put that next to there, next to the official cube. They're about half the size of the official cubes. They've got some slightly different features. So the joystick does move around, but also it's a switch as well that plunges. All 5 buttons click, but that's fine. And all the other features work. The spin dial works. The switch is nice and clunky. The front dials even click as they go round. But the reason I wanted to mention these is because they come with the lanyard loop attachment there. Inside the box you also get the lanyard. So what it does is it gives you basically a fidget cube keyring, which is really cool. So you can have your official fidget cube on your desk, or you know, even in your pocket or whatever. But you know, with my official fidget cubes, I don't want them to get damaged, don't want them to get scratched up. So yeah, I've been leaving mine on my desk where it can't, you know, can't get any injuries. And now the replacement's come for my broken one. I'm gonna stick this one on my workbench to fiddle away with and fidget with whilst I'm doing various things. But these little micro cubes are great. They're 22 millimeters across. The features all do work, although they are obviously a lot cheaper feeling than official cubes or even the full size fake cubes. They come in a range of colors. There's a white, I think there's about 20, 24 colors available, some madness. But the way I see these aren't, in my opinion, any sort of threat to the full size cube. These are novelty items, and they are basically fidget cube key rings. And mate, I kind of hope that Antsy Labs see these and think, yeah, that's a good idea, and produce an official version of these with high quality parts. They've got the rubberized vinyl on the casing, which is amazing for such a small and cheap cube. These are less than $4 each, normally including shipping. I've seen these as low as $2 from China, including shipping. That's how cheap these are. But when they arrive, I mean, all the sides are perfectly lined up. There's no gaps. All the features work, although, like I say, they do feel cheaper than the official cube. But they do work, and that's great. And so, for a few bucks, get one, throw it on your key ring, and then it's there when you're standing in queue waiting to pay for your petrol at a gas station, or in the supermarket at the checkout queue. So yeah, I just wanted to show you those just as a kind of extra, really, as a heads up, so yeah. Anyway, my main point, Antsy Labs, fantastic customer service. I really enjoyed chatting to Matt, and he's actually coming over here to the UK in a few months, and we'll meet up and have a drink in London, and talk shop, I suppose. I'm a maker, a manufacturer. I run a prototype workshop of my own. These guys have gone through the prototype process and onto the full manufacturing process of China. I've also been to China for 6 weeks a couple of years ago to oversee the manufacturing and distribution of a product for a friend of mine, and I've also run Kickstarters myself and helped others with Kickstarters as well. So and product wise, I produce a whole bunch of laser cut and 3D printed and injection molded products that are sold all across the southwest of England at markets and a couple of kitschy kind of gadgety type shops that like kind of alternative things, and at Christmas time I've got some really special things, and this year, coming up to Christmas, I'll do some reviews of those, but we're a long way away from there. So anyway, like I say, great customer service from the founders themselves. Nicely done with the revision of the packaging, both holding the base in inside the casing, and then holding the cube itself to that base. Even now, that's stuck on there perfectly. Even just like that would probably travel perfectly over land without a problem. So yeah, I know people are bitching and moaning and being little kids in the comments section on Kickstarter, but please just be patient. It's worth the wait. These cubes really are worth the wait. If you're still waiting on yours, it'll be with you soon, and hopefully this revision has carried across all the latest cubes, and we won't see any more people complaining about cubes detaching during shipping. So anyway, thanks guys. I hope this has been a good look and shows that Antsy, the official fidget cube makers, have really gone above and beyond to fix those issues that early recipients of a cube made them aware of, and they have They have gone and changed things and fixed things, and now it's great. The cubes arrive in tip-top condition, all features working, nothing smashed, and it's all good. So thanks to Antsy Labs, and yeah, that's it. So I will probably see you soon if people are interested. I'm going to be doing a few more reviews on some other things over the next week or two. Some kind of computer-based stuff. So keep an eye out for that if you're into hacking and making and programming and coding and electronics and all that kind of stuff. Keep an eye out for my videos over the next 2 or 3 weeks. So there you go. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and take care. Thanks a lot, guys, and bye.